Nick, thanks for doing this, man. How you doing?
I'm good, guys. How are you guys today?
You know, it's one of those. Yeah. Nick, I got to ask first off, because a lot of us were watching that entire pregame kind of play itself out in San Antonio. Was there ever a point where you looked at your guys and thought to yourself, I don't know if they can play today. I don't know if this game's going to happen.
Yeah, I mean, that's kind of your first instinct, especially when you take a look around the locker room, and it just seemed like it was tough, you know, on a lot of guys, and a lot of them have close relationships, you know. So, I didn't know if we were going to play or if we could play and how it was going to all unfold, to be honest with you.
There have been more than a few L.A. connections on your team over the last couple of years. I mean, from Norm Powell to Phil Handy. I know Norm spoke about spending the off season working out with Kobe. When you looked at that room, what did you see? Like, I know I don't want to get into conversations because those are personal, but like as a man, and I know that you've been through this before because you played a game a day after you lost your mom. Like, what did you see in that room?
I mean, there's a lot of emotion, right? You can and every guy was different. You know, there's tears being shed in there, and there's some shock and disbelief and a lot of sadness and just, you know, people, you know, mostly shocked by a tragedy that is really sad, you know?
A lot of our viewers are writing in right now, and a lot of them are asking us how you came up with the idea for the 24-second violations to honor Kobe. How did that idea manifest itself?
Well, we were about 10 minutes away from tip, and Alex McKechnie, who's our head of sports science and vice president for the Raptors, is back in my office there in the locker room with me, and he spent a lot of time with Kobe. You know, he worked for the Lakers for a lot of years, and I was just kind of saying out loud, we got to do something, and got out on the floor, talked to the refs, talked to Kyle, Fred, Pop, and just said, you know, I think we're going to hold the ball, and Pop would even pop one, you know, and Pop said, yep, we'll hold the ball, and we just decided to do it. I just thought we had to do something. 24 seconds, you know, we wore 24, and just to honor the guy, you know.
Raptors head coach Nick Nurse here on Tim and Sid. Nick, for a moment, and this is from an outside looking in perspective, and I know you don't control these things, but I'm thinking at home in Toronto, how they're going to postpone the schedule, right? Mm-hmm. Like they're going to postpone the entire schedule, maybe Friday of All-Star break, Monday of all, whatever, replay the games. Mm-hmm. Was there any talk from the league to you guys about possibly do that? Did you catch wind of that? Or do you think that was never really on the table and the game was going to go forward?
No, I'm sure there was this guy. I mean, that's like I didn't catch any wind of it, but you know, that's Bobby Webster there talking to the league, and you know, I don't think that they just saw feasibly how to do it. You know, I don't know. I think they were discussing it, but we were just going on again. We were so short, kind of, it was right before, you know, it was 45 minutes or something before where we were, and you know, that's time where we're zeroing in and there's film to be show, you know, normally, and all this stuff. So we were just, you know, trying to continue on with our job until somebody told us differently, you know.
The one thing I remember that you said a day after your mother passed away was, you said, I'm here because my mother wouldn't want it any other way. I thought the same thing as Sid initially, where I was like, what the hell are these guys doing out there? And then I thought to myself, given the competitor that Kobe Bryant was, don't you think he would have wanted it that way?
Yeah, I think so. You know, I think that it's a good example. I told the team that last year, you know, I'm here. I'm here because my mom would kick my butt if I wasn't here, you know, and I think it was a little bit of a similar deal. I didn't say that to the guys, but I said, you know, Kobe was a great worker. He was a great competitor. You know, take something from that if you can. And even if you don't feel like playing, let me know. You know, I get it. We'll find. You know, we'll try somebody else, or we'll do the best we can. Let's just stick together, man, and get through it, and honor him and play the game, and let's get back home to our families.
What impressed you most about Kobe's career?
Oh, I think for me it was I just think he really intently, with intensity, studied the game. You know, I think he was super high energy and super high intellect, and he was driving himself to where he got to. And I don't know. I mean, I wasn't around him all that much. I did have one. I went out to Phil Jackson's very first practice when he took over the Lakers. It was a summer league practice when they just hired Phil. I was trying to learn the triangle offense, and Kobe was sitting right next to me. We both had two folded chairs there at midcourt, and he was sitting right next to me, and we never spoke because he was just locked in on trying to listen to everything Phil was teaching these young summer league players, and that struck me as that he was sitting there at midcourt, you know, and was just totally locked in.
Yeah, he's got that old school in him.
Yeah, makes total sense. Nick, this has been a hell of a 24 hours here. You've been great. We'll let you go. Just one last personal note on my end. The professionalism you guys continue to show, I just think you should be applauded for it.
Yeah.
And I have nothing else to say but that. That was incredible. Thank you very much for joining us, Nick.
Okay. Thanks, guys.